Hello everybody, this is Jessica with Stamp a Blessing. Welcome to my channel. Today I would like to show you what I am doing with a new stamp set from Stampin' Up called Falling for Leaves. I just created the most wonderful tag and I want to show you the one I made and the ones my team made, the Blessed Stampers. So I have some good news for you and I want to announce them at the end. Stay tuned. Okay, so let me start sharing with you what we will be using today. We will use the Photopolymer Stamp Set Falling for Leaves. It's absolutely beautiful. I love the sentiment and we will be using it today. We will also be using the Detailed Leaves Thinlets Dies. My favorite from the holiday, not the holiday, yes, it's the holiday catalog. Love it, love it, love it. We will be using Blackberry Bliss Stamping Pad and we'll use a little bit of vanilla cardstock, very vanilla. We will use some mint macaroon and I will be placing some of these measurements at the bottom of my video in just a little bit. We will use Calypso Coral and also Mango Melody and you will need a circle of that. Besides, we will also add some cellophane bags, whichever you have are totally fine. These are 4x6 and to make it fun, add some chocolate. Okay, so we will start this project by stamping because that's my favorite part. And we will take the sentiment that says thinking of you with a grateful heart and we will stamp it right on top of our circle. I'm using Blackberry Bliss ink pad. Beautiful. And then we will grab this beautiful leaf and we will be stamping that on mint macaroon. When we are done stamping, we're going to proceed to cut our pieces that we will need for this. And we will be needing one of these big leaves right here. We will also be cutting through this wonderful framelit. And we will use this one in Bermuda Bay, just a piece of Bermuda Bay cardstock to cut through this. Last but not least, we will take this piece and we will be cutting it with this one. Let's put it through the Big Shot. Now that we have all of our pieces ready to assemble, I will take this little 4x4 square, I scored it in half and I'm going to fold it. And I'm going to start adding first my border. And the way I did, very, very simple. I just add a little bit of glue at the top of this. I did not add any glue at the bottom. Just at the top, and we're going to position it here. Right there. Then I will take one of my leaves. I love my tumble glue. So let's just assemble things. Now, besides this project, I want to show you so many more that my team made during this swap. This was actually a swap that we sent to each other. And one of my teammates, Margarita, sent this one. Look how beautiful. Your thoughtfulness brightened my day. She even added chocolate. We were not necessarily adding chocolates, but she sent it with a chocolate and I loved it. I have this one from my friend Maria. Look how beautiful. And you can just add your cellophane bag with chocolate or whatever gift you have at the bottom. Love it. This was from my friend Patricia. Friends make the good times better. Don't you think that's so gorgeous? I love her pumpkin. It's punch art. Check the one that Miss Nancy made. Look at that gorgeous, gorgeous embossing. Ooh, I love the copper that she used in there. And then I also have a need Look how beautiful and simple. I think this one's go very, very well with the same bags that I use. Right like that. Yes. Love it. Last but not least, I had a beautiful surprise from Sarah. Happy for y'all. And she not only added, many of them added recipes, but one of the most beautiful things that Miss Patricia, who is leading the swaps in our team right now, did was giving ideas. And Miss Sarah shared one of her recipes. Margarita also shared a recipe. And not only recipes, but we've been sharing just cool gifts. Look at this. Everybody sends different gifts, stamped images, die cuts, Bible verses that inspire each other. And this has been such a blessing. Every time you receive a swap, it's like receiving a hug in the mail. And that was exactly the name that we call our swaps. So I want to show you some of the gifts that they have been given. Don't you think this is certainly a hug in the mail? And check out the different ideas. I am just enjoying having this team, and I've been so blessed with them. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody that belongs to Blessed Stampers. Miss Sarah also sent us a card each to be sending to people that are suffering of cancer during the month of October. She actually made the cards herself, and she encouraged us to send them to others. Isn't that beautiful? Courage is fear that has said its prayers. And she sent it in honor of some family members and friends that she lost. She even sent us an envelope. So I am so excited to send this, to send hope to somebody. Then I have a beautiful friend, my friend Faith, who also follows some of my ideas on my YouTube videos with a vellum. And look how, what a beautiful card she sent me this month. She even heat embossed on top of the vellum and then stamp under. That is absolutely gorgeous, and I loved her idea. I got a thank you card from my friend Gloria, and I have to tell you, I am so blessed to share this with you because her cards are marvelous. She actually drew this by hand, and it just blessed me so much. I loved it, and it comes together with a word that the Lord gave me with about birds, and it just confirmed so much to my heart. So this has been such a blessing. My friend Margarita also sent me another gift not long ago, and I was so mega blessed. Look what gorgeous box she created. She actually sent me a gift in this box that she made with a beautiful card, and she sent me the earrings that I'm wearing today. Last but not least, I want to bless you with some of the card swaps that they've been sending me in the last month. This was actually one of our first swaps. This was made by Maria with a beautiful U stamp set. Gorgeous. This one was made by Nancy. Thank you, Nancy. I love that stamp set. I'll be adding the stamp sets at the bottom because I don't remember all the names. This was made by my friend Sarah. I love it. This was made by Margarita. Thank you, Margarita. All of them are precious. Look at this beautiful card by Enid. You have to check the inside. Ta-da! Look at that. It's so cool. I've never made this type of card. And this was my swap during it. And I also have Miss Patricia's. Here it is, absolutely gorgeous with envelope and all. I thank you, everybody that has been watching with me today, this video. I hope you enjoyed all the ideas. I'm super blessed to have the Blessed Stampers. If you are interested in joining our team, we all love Jesus, we all love stamping, and we love to share the love of Christ through CardMate. And you must be wondering, what are the good news that I have for you? Well, I woke up this morning, and do you sometimes wake up thinking, I need to hear some good news? My goodness, there's bad news everywhere. And I open my Holy Bible app. Do you have that app? Really cool app. I open it and I check the verse for the day. And this verse came to mind, and I was just reading it and I was amazed. It is the New International Reader's Version. Totally different version that I usually read. It says, I know the plans I have for you, announces the Lord. I want you to enjoy success. I do not plan to harm you. I will give you hope for the years to come. And this may become familiar for you. It comes from Jeremiah 29:11. But the way that this version paraphrases that, I want you to enjoy success, it just brought to me the heart of the Father. And I want to announce to you what He announces to you too. He has good plans for you. Plans not to harm you, but to give you hope and a future. And I love that it's an announcement. It's good news for you. So I wanted you to hear this. Do you trust Him with the outcome? He may be asking you to sow, and you may be sowing for a long time, do not get tired of doing what is good, because the outcome will be good. He wants you to enjoy success, and He delights in you. Remember this quote that says, I do not know what my future holds, but I know who holds my future. Thank you for being here. I hope this idea has inspired you. Please tell me which of all inspired you the most. God bless you.